Surprise is an insubstantial blade, a sword worthless in a war. It breaks when troops rally. It snaps when commanders hold the line. But fear never fades. Fear is a blade that sharpens with use. So let the enemy know we come. Let their fears defeat them as everything falls dark. As the world's sun sets, as the city is reaved in its final night, let 10,000 howls premise 10,000 claws. The Night Lords are coming, and no soul that stands against us shall see another dawn.
Of the founding legions of the Adeptus Astartes, many have cited the relative ease that some were corrupted by the lure of chaos. For whilst there are legions whose resolve and loyalty are without question, there are those who have always been regarded by their peers as unstable, or in some cases, even inherently malevolent. As such, today we shall elucidate the history of one such legion, who arguably had fallen well before the betrayal of the Horus Heresy. The brutal killers of Nostromo, the Night Lords. Formed on Holy Terror from the dregs of humanity from within the linked prison sinks, the condemned of the underground ruins of Terror would live in unending darkness. Starved of food, gutting one another, and delving into the pits of madness, these depraved survivors of the worst of Terror circumstance would hone their skills of murder and backstabbing. Children would be born from the madness, cradled in bloodshed, fear, and the ever-present embrace of death. These night's children would grow to be more savage than even the adult populace. Their ashen, light-deprived features, striking a clear contrast with the more noble Astartes aspirants of their contemporaries. Used to suppress revolt and rebellion amongst the Terran populace, the Eighth would be tasked with only the most cruel of tactics to enforce compliance to the Imperium. For those who sinned in their efforts to devolve back into the habits of old night, the Eighth Legion would bring merciless retribution. Culling the March of 10 million, the cybreeding of the Court of Antaeus, and the atrocities caused by the Saragorn Enclave, the Eighth Legion would enact their obsession to purge the sinful with which the Night's children had been raised to endure since their birth. There would be no innocence, no excuse, only rivers of blood. No grey areas, only black and white, judgment. Disgusted by their own existence, the fledgling Eighth Legion would seek to slay every monster of the galaxy as absolution for their own degeneracy. Yet the Legion would soon be reunited with their Primarch, and their quest for exculpation would be further tested. The Emperor of Mankind would never see the potential of his gene son, Conrad Kurz, fulfilled with his provenance squandered upon the world of Nostromo. The sunless hive world would be characterized by its rampant crime, suffering, and corruption. Rich in adamantium ore deposits, the wealthy would lord over the populace whilst growing fat as pollution spewed from the mines and factories of the planet. Under the watchful eyes of the planet's iron overseers, sons of toil, and hands of Corrugado, the gangs of Nostromo would give fealty to the barons, counts, and other noble lords of the planet in exchange for the authority to enact their twisted justice. With Conrad Kerr's gestation capsule landing on Nostromo Quintus, the capsule would burrow into the heart of the planet and stop near the world's unstable core. Destroying the adamantium deposits during the descent, the Primarch would be sealed within the scarred rend of surface. Though it is unclear as to how the infant Primarch would escape his tomb, Kurz would survive his journey to the surface. Living amongst the sprawling spires of Nostromo Quintus, the being whom would be known as the Night Haunter would skulk the darkness until growing in stature. Committing many atrocities amongst the populace, martial law would be enacted on Nostromo's hive cities to protect its citizenry. Yet the Night Haunter would diminish the crime rate of the planet to nothing within a year. The Nostromans would not dare to leave their homes after the self-imposed curfew, with even mothers of their children warning their progeny of the being that skulked the streets. poised to rule the planet by sheer surrender of their rights in exchange for safety. The new dictator of Nostromo would oversee the planet's new order to burgeon prosperity, fairness, and honesty. Yet with the arrival of the Emperor of Mankind during 896.M30, Nostromo's fortunes would turn sour. Submitting to the Emperor, Kurz would accept his duty to lead the 8th Legion. Studying the tactics and doctrines of the Adeptus Astartes under the tutelage of his brother Primarch, Fulgrim, Kurz would lead his newly renamed Legion, the Night Lords. Akin to the Witch Hunters of ancient Terra, the Night Lords would purge the galaxy of enemies foolish enough to stand against the Imperial Creed. Highly effective in their methods of waging war, their drastic and cruel tactics, whilst decried by the other legions, would see to the rapid compliance of worlds with minimal casualties, bringing rebellious planets into line with the mere mention of the 8th's deployment. No other legion would come close to instilling such boundless fear within the minds of the enemies of the Imperium. With Kurz's departure from Nostromo, his recruits from the world would soon be tainted with the dissolution of the planet's laws. For with no Night Haunter to hound them, the Nostromans would devolve back into cruelty and lawlessness, to which the new Astartes recruits would be derived from little more than gutter rats. With such recruits' adoption into the Legion, its turn to more noble prospects would be distorted and corrupted. Despising his own gene sons, Kurz would be discontent with his new life, seemingly doomed to fail. No matter his struggle or intent, the Night Lords would never be alike to his brother's legions. They were murderers, first, last, and always. And for Kurz more than any, he would see portents of the future. Visions of endless darkness, suffering, and madness. Revered as the most petty of all the legions, the Night Lords would willingly soak their hands in the blood of entire planets without qualm. Enacting exterminatus on many worlds, the atrocities enacted in the name of the 8th would continue to cement their downward spiral of betrayal. Returning to their homeworld during 984.M30, the Night Lords would observe Nostromo to have once more become a pit of criminality. Firing the Night Lords' fleet's lance batteries into the core of the planet, Nostromo would be torn apart, and in doing so, untether the 8th Legion from their ties to the Imperium. An act of defiance so grave, the Emperor would recall the Night Lords to Holy Terra and their Primarch to answer for his crimes. Believing his actions to fall in line with the Emperor's own methods of waging war, the embittered Primarch would be castigated for the destruction of his homeworld. The Imperium would punish the Night Lords by refusing to ship supplies to sectors held by the 8th Legion and banish them to the vanguard of the Great Crusade. And though their penance would be complete with the dawn of the 31st millennium, the Night Lords' memory would be found resentful of their treatment and align them with a new power growing within the galaxy. For with the rise of the corrupted Warmaster, Horus Lupercal, and the betrayal of the legions of the Emperor's children, World Eaters, Death Guard, and Sons of Horus, the Night Lords would see an opportunity. A chance to seek retribution against the Imperium, the Emperor, and all whom it slighted and repressed their nature. The beginning of the civil war known as the Horus Heresy. Already at odds with the Imperium, the Night Lords would need little encouragement to rebel. Joining the traitorous betrayal of the Istvan V Dropside Massacre, Kurz and his Night Lords would slaughter their loyalist brethren with glee as the might of the Warmaster's rebellion would swiftly destroy the first challenge to their wrath. With the ever-increasing madness of their Primarch, the 8th Legion would begin to doubt their actions, yet stand unified against their hated foes. Enacting the Framas Crusade without the supervision of Kurz, the Night Lords would seek to challenge the Dark Angels Legion to test their pride. Yet within the Legion of the Night Lords, the fate of their Primarch would be split. Some wished him to regain the splendor of his past, whilst others plotted to see him descend further into madness. Unable to match the Dark Angels due to their inability to contest their discipline, the Night Lords would begin to fragment as the Framas Crusade waged on. Retreating from the Framas sector, the Night Lords would lose contact with their Primarch and be split into warbands of varying sizes. Though some warbands aided the Warmaster during the Siege of Terra, it would not be sufficient enough to conquer the indomitable defenders of the Imperial Palace. Retreating to the eastern fringes of the galaxy, the Night Lords would turn on themselves in a power struggle to replace their absent Primarch. Unwilling to accept or acknowledge the flaws within themselves as the cause of their misfortune, the Night Lords would continue to lay their path to damnation. With the Night Haunter discovered within a jettisoned sarcophagus by the salvage ship, the Sheldrun, Kurz would manage to return to the planet that had decided the fate of the Framas Crusade, Sagwalza. Rejoining his sons, Conrad Kurz would not live long enough to reform his broken legion. For a Calidus assassin, Meshen would infiltrate the Night Lord's fortress housing the Primarch, and with his blessing, slay the Night Haunter. For Kurz had been tormented with visions of the future for centuries, and had seen his death many times by the assassin's hand. As a defiant martyrdom against the Emperor, Kurz would relish his death and accept it without qualm. Demanding that his sons would not seek reprisal from the assassin, his last wish would be ignored, for soon after, Meshen would also be slain. The Night Lords would further splinter into feuding warbands and relocate to the Eye of Terra. Deteriorating as the millennia passed, the Night Lords are now merely a shadow of their former strength. Hired as mercenaries and pirates by more powerful and prevalent warbands, the Night Lords also aid in the prolonged wars waged by the Warmaster, Abaddon the Despoiler, and his Black Crusades. Renewed with purpose with the expanse of the Great Rift during the Era Indomitus, the Night Lords prey on the worlds of the Imperium, cut off from the Emperor's light. Raiding fortress monasteries, gene seed banks, and munitions depots, the Night Lords are rebuilding their legion, piece by arduous piece. The screams of their victims heralding the sickening rebirth of the damned Eighth Legion. Despite their unassuming and disorganized origins, the Night Lords in their prime employed a variety of specialists and elite squadrons within their ranks. The Chiroptera would advise their Primarch as confidants and counselors. Consisting of the Night Haunter's most trusted lieutenants, the Chiroptera would function independent of the Legion's wider command structure, yet temper the Legion's decisions and doctrines. The Atramentar comprised the most elite members of the Legion into their first company, personally selected by Conrad Kurz. Originally led by First Captain Jago Sevatarian, the Atramentar would be decked in Terminator armor and wreak havoc as a unified force. Noted for their cruelty and ferocity, with the dissolution of the Legion, so too would the elite First Company fragment, with its members forming their own warbands or serving as bodyguards of their patron Chaos Lords. The Conticar would mete out shock trooper deployments against their enemies, sowing despair, terror, and panic amongst their enemies. Formed of the most savage murderers and butchers of the Legion, the Conticar would gain a reputation during the Great Crusade as the most effective means of demoralizing non-compliant worlds. Burning agriculture, toppling infrastructure, and demolishing the very foundations of societies, the Conticar would be commanded by only their Primarch and First Captain due to their severe methods. The Legion's terror squads would be formed of those willing to brutalize their enemies using torture, mutilation, and flaying. The dispassionate souls of the terror squads would enact their cruelly imaginative arts upon their enemies that are now too unspeakable to detail. Unstable and unsubtle, the members of the terror squads would be outcasts even within their own Legion, often marked for death and serving as penance for their depraved crimes. And finally, the Night Raptors would specialize in massacres initiated by aerial assault. So potent would their assaults be, the Raptors would serve as the example for all Chaos Space Marine Raptor assault troops to follow, regardless of their gene origins or lineage. Led by their Talon Master, their Lightning Claws or Unguis Raptus would be so efficient in meting out slaughter during the Great Crusade, their reputation would be unnerving yet unparalleled in its efficacy. Utilizing close-quarters melee weapons and jump packs, the raptors would conduct raids of overwhelming might and speed in order to decimate their foes. The gangs of Nostromo would heavily influence the hierarchy of the Legion. Following the examples of Astartes legions that had gone before, the Night Lords would field a variety of units for each squad deployed. Breacher siege squads would be rare within the 8th, due to their tactics being broadly uncharacteristic for the Legion's preference for war. Designated simply as claws, which would contain talons, each claw would be given a numbered signifier or honorific to denote rank. Each claw would comprise of anywhere between 100 to 1,000 Astartes during the Great Crusade. Companies' monikers would be divined usually by its commanding officer, with some examples being the Shattered Skull, the Crimson Judges, and the Scions of the Bloody Claw. Highly malleable in their command structure, the 8th Legion would hold to the outlining of chapter and battalion sizes loosely, allowing for autonomous and highly self-sufficient formations to function with little oversight. Overall command would fall to the Dark King, Conrad Kurz, yet his Gene Son's loyalty would be continually strained. Resentment would grow within the Legion, with the elite Chiroptera dispensing justice and leading by their Primarch's example in his absence. Followed by the elite First Company, the Atramentar, and then the captains of each company, the Night Lords would serve begrudgingly under the watchful eye of their senior officers. Disparate ranks would also arise due to necessity, such as captains who would command several companies at once. These stalwarts of the Legion would be known as commanders, master regents, or other such haughty titles. Yet should any weakness or opportunity for mutiny present itself, those below them would scheme to overthrow their masters. With some master regents commanding several captains, some would be undermined by captains whom served as members of the Chiroptera, creating power struggles within the senior ranks. Many captains would bear monikers regaling their deeds prior to the Legion, with titles such as Sightless Revenant, Painted Count, and The Bloodless, usually serving as ironic insults that undermined their senior officer's authority. Numbering in estimates of 90,000 to 120,000 Astartes during the Great Crusade, their rapid psycho-conditioning, hastened gene seed implantation, and subjugation of worlds allowed for quick assimilation for aspirants to join the Legion. Experts in sowing fear into the minds of their enemies, the Night Lords target communications in order to broadcast the screams of their victims to those who elude their grasp. Records exist of prolonged transmissions of screaming aimed to rupture the eardrums of enemy opposition, allowing for swift slaughter upon the deafened and distraught enemies of the 8th. Unwilling to face their enemies on a fair footing, it is uncommon for the Night Lords to combat enemies which they cannot crush with overwhelming force or a decisive victory. Giving no mercy to their enemies, woe betide any whom should cross their path with numbers unable to face them. The Night Lords only take prisoners in order to please their lust for mutilation and hold no beliefs of a higher order nor morality to their actions. Absent of honor, ethics, or a need to better themselves, the Night Lords, even during their time serving the Great Crusade, would bring compliance with no code for their new subjects to follow, with exception for the subjects of each world to escape their wrath. Similar to the Raven Guard, with their affinity to use stealth to ambush their enemies, the Night Lords bear similarity to stalking predators. Shockingly brutal in their strikes, the Night Lords are masters of nurturing confusion and chaos amongst their enemies' ranks. The flayed bodies of the fallen, markers for their encroachment into enemy lines and reminders of the fates that should befall any who dare to survive their initial onslaught. Relatively unchanged by the reunion of their Primarch, Conrad Kurz, the 8th Legion would adopt gallows humor and snide remarks against authority, which would see them distanced from the more noble legions of the Adeptus Astartes. Fatalistic and adapting gang customs from the Legion's homeworld of Nostromo, Astartes marked for death would have their gauntlets painted red to show them as living on borrowed time. Punishment would be rife within the Legion with the introduction of its Nostraman customs and Astartes. The Terran-born Astartes of the Legion would swiftly integrate with their peers due to their shared heritage of darkness and struggle. Yet despite this, rivalries would be rife within the Legion, as the Eighth would be nothing if not prideful. Titles either from aristocratic or gang-related pasts would be called into question, and infighting would be rampant. The macabre flayed skins of their enemies adorning their armor and vehicles as symbols of what would befall those who would dare stand in their path. Despite their actions, the gene seed of the Night Lords would, in its initial stages, prove to be incredibly incorruptible. With their fall to chaos, the Night Lords would be the most reliable in their resistance of warp mutations, and as a majority reject the lore of the ruinous powers. Inheriting much of their paranoia and sadism from the example of their Primarch, the Night Lords would devolve from a promisingly pure legion into one of the most depraved amongst the initial founding. More renegades than chaos corrupted, the Night Lords scavenge and scrounge for the means to survive. Employing slaves and pilfering armor and technologies from loyalist marines, the Night Lords are aimless in comparison to their chaos-aligned brethren. Yet it is almost unsurprising that the Eighth Legion would be poised to fall from grace with their origins and appearance combined. Their pale skin and jet-black pupils striking fear into any Imperial citizen, the Night Lords would be adapted to living within the uncaring darkness of Nostromo and beyond. Able to see within the most pitch of darkness, the Night Lords' name is not given lightly due to their uncanny ability to see infrared with their so-called prey sight. Able to emit deafeningly loud shrieks to overwhelm their victims, the Night Lords, though disdainful of employing demons or warp-sworn entities to do their bidding, can become almost indistinguishable to such beings to the eyes and ears of a terrified victim. Venerating symbols of death with their inception to the Imperium, the Night Lords have always harnessed the raw strength inherent with the trappings of fear, misery, and suffering. Their armor embellished with fanged skulls, bat wings, and glowing red eyes, the murderers of Nostromo would care not for their reputation and infamy within the wider Imperium. In midnight clad, the Legion would employ lightning streaks upon their armor and embolden their sinister image with human bones and skull designs on their faceplates. Their use of splayed rib cages, femurs, skulls, and bone meal, laying their sinister designs bare to the universe, the Night Lords have never shied away from their origins of cannibalism, murder, and ruthless endurance. Believing the victims of their slaughter to imbue their bones, only the totems of their most terrified of victims adorn their armor. Yet despite their seeming affinity and trappings bearing similarity to the ruinous powers, the Night Lords show great disgust and disdain for the gods of chaos, and as such, in the majority of cases, deny and abhor their gifts and allegiance. Since their fall from grace, their scavenging has expunged their unified markings and armor patterns due to the necessity to keep their equipment in working order. Mismatched and uncanny compared to loyalist or even chaos-aligned Astartes, the Night Lords roam the galaxy as nomadic and bitter warbands. Bereft of their gene father, Legion ideals, and a cause to rally behind, the Eighth Legion survive on the scraps of a careless galaxy with little more than a primal need to survive. Regarded as some of the most terrible and feared traitors roaming the galaxy, the Night Lords prey on the weak and enact their despicable acts of sadism to those unfortunate enough to stand in their way. Bearing no allegiance to any of the forces of chaos, the Night Lords act as mercenaries to any whom will pay for their skill at arms. Motivated by bloodlust, wealth, and a need to kill, only the most foolish of men or warp-spawned beasts would ally with such cutthroats. For the sons of Conrad Kurz have maimed countless warriors, innocents, and machinations of the warp for centuries. And when they come for you, it would be advisable to hide.
My sons, the galaxy is burning. We all bear witness to a final truth. Our way is not the way of the Imperium. You have never stood in the Emperor's light, never worn the Imperial Eagle, and you never will. You shall stand in midnight clad, your claws forever red with the lifeblood of my father's failed empire, warring through the centuries as the talons of a murdered god. Rise, my sons, and take your wrath across the stars in my name, in my memory. Rise, my Night Lords.
This has been a tale of the great Imperium of Man, read by the Remembrancer. The Night Lords have always been amongst tainted stock of the Astartes, necessary tools to fulfill the conquest of the Emperor, fit only to be put down now that they have bitten the hand that feeds. Yet in our next transmission, we shall elucidate the noble mirror to the Night Lords, the masked in shadow, yet loyal and noble Astartes, the Raven Guard.